University School of Milwaukee was formed in 1964 when three independent schools merged. USM's predecessor schools, Milwaukee University School, Milwaukee Country Day, and Milwaukee Downer Seminary, each brought its own rich traditions and history, dating back to the mid-1800s and early 1900s. This 2014-2015 school year, University School of Milwaukee celebrates the 50th anniversary of the merger of those three schools. But we make special note of the fact that our school's history truly dates back over 160 years. What better way to begin a year of celebration than by taking a closer look at our roots? Wisconsin becomes a state in 1848. At this time in history, there aren't many educational opportunities for girls and women. Girls are expected to grow up to become wives and mothers. They are not expected to have professions. Despite this, Milwaukee's more progressive-minded women and men formally charter Milwaukee Female Seminary, an all-girls school, in the year 1851. The school thrives, building a reputation for strong and comprehensive academics, for nurturing in the girls a sense of community responsibility, and for holding an activist approach to providing opportunities for women. A series of leadership, campus, and school name changes culminates in 1933 with the establishment of Milwaukee Downer Seminary, which remains true to its roots to provide girls and young women with a comprehensive education. The seminary is located on what is today the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee campus, but by 1959, because of UWM's rapid growth and the seminary's desire to remain more rural, the school purchases land on West Ferry Chasm Road and begins construction of a new school, building what would eventually become University School of Milwaukee's lower school and middle school. Milwaukee in the 19th century, a growing city but one with limited educational opportunities. In 1851, German immigrants formed the German English Academy to fill the educational void. The academy soon builds a reputation for social inclusiveness, concern for the community, and high educational standards. Noted for its progressive philosophies, the academy starts Milwaukee's first kindergarten program in 1875. And in 1891, in keeping with the philosophy of strong mind, strong body, the Academy builds the first school gymnasium in the United States. It is an inclusive school, enrolling both girls and boys from a wide variety of geographical and socioeconomic backgrounds. This is a unique environment for this time in history. When the United States enters World War I in 1917, anti-German sentiment is widespread and often directed at the school. Students look for ways to distance themselves from the Academy's German heritage. The Board of Trustees votes in 1918 to change the Academy's name to Milwaukee University School. Despite the name change, the hallmarks of inclusiveness and commitment to service, both within the school and in the larger community, remain integral to the learning environment, just as in the school's earliest days. In 1911, St. Bernard School is established as an all-boys school. Because of its popularity, the school quickly grows out of its early downtown Milwaukee location, and in 1917, renames itself as the Milwaukee Country Day School. A new campus is constructed in northern Milwaukee County, the present site of the Harry and Rose Sampson Family Jewish Community Center in Whitefish Bay. Rural surroundings, a long school day, close parent-teacher cooperation, and a unified, homogeneous student body characterize this so-called Country Day educational model. disciplined academics are the Milwaukee Country Day standard, and student personal conduct is also very strictly monitored. But student achievements are also readily acknowledged. There are annual prizes for loyalty, service, academic improvement, and for making significant contributions to the school. Early in the school's history, Country Day's leaders decide that strenuous sport is good preparation for life in the adult world. Athletics dominate the school culture. Many Country Day students participate in athletics and refer to themselves as intellectual jocks. Country Day student life is a rich experience for its young men. The advantages of consolidation compel the three schools' boards and leaders to make the decision to merge in 1963. It is a difficult decision, with special attention given to the question of how to blend the traditions and cultures of three different institutions. Milwaukee University School brings to the merger traditions of curricular strength, co-education, and social diversity. Milwaukee Downer Seminary is a bastion of women's education, a center of academic rigor, and a staunch advocate of a greater role for women in society. Milwaukee Country Day School prides itself on faculty leadership, athletics, and the development of ethical behavior. But despite the differences, the vast majority of the new community is willing to make the merger work. Students choose the name Wildcats, and all three predecessor schools are reflected in the choice of school colors: blue for Milwaukee University School, white for Downer Seminary, and gold for Country Day. Maintaining two campuses for a time, the Country Day campus in Whitefish Bay and Downer Seminary's Ferry Chasm Road campus, the school consolidates at its current location in 1985. In the 50 years since the merger, much has changed. Our campus has grown, and our school has become one of the top college preparatory schools in the nation. But we hold on to our roots: academic excellence, integrity, passionate faculty, a culture of involvement, competitive athletics, inclusiveness, University School of Milwaukee, 50 years strong, over 160 years of tradition.